Before Russell Wilson parted ways with the Seattle Seahawks, the relationship with the team had already been deteriorating. One of the issues was that defenders for the Seahawks developed resentment because they thought Carroll gave Wilson special treatment. Upon his move to the Denver Broncos, things haven't been going as planned, making people wonder if the Denver Broncos now regret purchasing him because of his under-par performances. Watch this video for full details. First up, the Russell Wilson Seattle Seahawks drama that resulted in the Denver Broncos trade. Russell Wilson watched Super Bowl 55 fuming while seated next to his wife and NFL Commissioner Roger Goodell in a lavish suite at Raymond James Stadium. The game was a disturbing reminder of what Wilson desired and didn't have, of where his career stood after 9 seasons with the Seattle Seahawks in comparison to the quarterbacks on the field before him. For Wilson, who was in Tampa, Florida to receive his Walter Payton NFL Man of the Year award. On one side, there was 43-year-old Tom Brady, who endured 2 hits the whole game while winning his 7th Super Bowl with a team of star players, including 3 that the Tampa Bay Buccaneers had signed at his request. On the other side was Patrick Mahomes, who had won an MVP award thanks to the pass-happy Kansas City Chiefs offense, which saw him complete 49 passes. 2 days after that Super Bowl in February 2021, Wilson would state on the Dan Patrick Show that one plays the game to be the best in the world, and that he hated watching other guys play the game while he stood around doing nothing. Wilson felt upset, and in his eyes, the time had come to take action. Wilson voiced those annoyances in an interview with Patrick and during a Zoom meeting planned to discuss his Man of the Year award. He lashed out at pass protection and what he saw to be his apparent lack of influence over personnel choices in comparison to other elite quarterbacks. He made several references to his legacy and stated it was far too many, that he had been fired about 400 times in his career, the most in players' first 9 seasons since the 1970 merger, according to ESPN stats and information. The Super Bowl, Wilson's remarks, and the subsequent trade discussions turned out to be the key turning points in the long-term deterioration of his relationship with the Seahawks. In exchange for Drew Locke, Shelby Harris, and Noah Fant, Denver's first and second round picks in each of the following 2 drafts, as well as a 2022 fifth-round pick, Seattle traded Wilson to the Denver Broncos 13 months later. People involved in the Wilson-Seahawks split, such as the quarterback's friends and family, as well as members of Seattle's front office, coaching staff, and players, described the dysfunctional environment that led up to the eventual breaking point for ESPN. Wilson felt he was being held back by his organization and coach Pete Carroll, so he wanted out. Wilson lost faith in the Seahawks, just as they had lost faith in him due to their concerns about how his game was maturing. Wilson's 7-year teammate and former Seahawks wide receiver Doug Baldwin stated that from his perspective, the divorce was inevitable and had been brewing for many years. Up next, Wilson and MVP chances with the Seattle Seahawks. Wilson was one of the top early season MVP contenders going into an October 2019 game against the Atlanta Falcons because of his strong start to the season. Wilson hoped to win the award. Wilson had a chance to gain ground because the Baltimore Ravens, who eventually won, and Lamar Jackson were off. Only 5 passes were attempted by him in the second half, despite the Seahawks jumping out to a 24-0 lead at the interval after he had thrown 2 touchdown passes. Wilson was furious with Carroll afterward, reportedly lashing out at him for letting off the throttle, feeling it had cost him a chance to win the MVP award. This was according to a source who spoke with the quarterback. A year later, Wilson would find himself back in the MVP discussion early in the season, to the satisfaction of Wilson and the supporters of Let Russell Cook, a social media campaign and term that Wilson would eventually trademark for charitable purposes. The Seahawks entered the 2020 season intending to rely more on Wilson's arm. Wilson mentioned 4 all-time greats he aspired to join: Peyton Manning, Tom Brady, Drew Brees, and Joe Montana. Wilson was used more than ever by Carroll and the offensive coordinator Brian Schottenheimer to lead the offense. And during a 5-0 start, he threw 19 touchdown passes to just 3 interceptions, earning him unquestioned recognition as the early MVP frontrunner. Wilson said he didn't want to vote, referring to the fact that throughout his career, he hasn't earned one. Wilson hasn't garnered a vote for MVP in part because of the voting procedure, in which each of the 50 voters makes only one selection. However, the fact that he was in charge of one of the NFL's more run-centric schemes didn't help. The Seahawks have ranked 29th in design pass play rate since his rookie season. Since Wilson signed his first mega deal in 2015, they are 21st. When the productive run gave way to the greatest turnover slump of his career, Wilson's chances of winning his first MVP in 2020 quickly diminished. The Seahawks lost all three of their remaining games as a result of Wilson's 10 turnovers during the subsequent four contests. In that time, Wilson had 7 interceptions, one of which was in Week 10's defeat at the hands of the Los Angeles Rams. Carroll was tired of making mistakes. He ended "Let Russ Cook" and went back to the strategy that had been established in the coach since he was 69 years old. The Seahawks placed 15th in design pass rate over the final 7 weeks after dropping back to pass more than any other team during the first 10 weeks. Up next, Denver Broncos' expectations from the Russell Wilson trade and how it's going. The Denver Broncos must be the NFL team currently experiencing regret over a significant offseason acquisition in 2022, right? The Broncos acquired Russell Wilson from the Seattle Seahawks in exchange for their second-round pick in the 2022 NFL Draft, as well as their first and second-round picks in the 2023 NFL Draft, along with 3 players. At the time, it was a significant cost to bear, and looking back on the transaction, it was more significant than Broncos GM George Patton had imagined. The top 5 picks in each round of the 2023 NFL Draft appeared to be those players. The idea that the Seahawks could be able to win the NFC West, and with one of the best offenses in the NFL, have a ton of new building blocks already in place from the 2022 offseason, and still have multiple picks in the first 2 rounds of the 2023 NFL Draft, must have had them licking their lips. The Denver Broncos believe that acquiring Russell Wilson would instantly elevate them to contender status in the AFC, let alone the AFC West. Unfortunately, they are 0-3 so far this season in the NFC West play, and as of right now, Denver has nothing to show for the Wilson trade except for a bunch of booing fans every week. Of course, the season's almost over, so this makes no sense. Russell Wilson has also only thrown 7 touchdown passes through 9 games, which is embarrassingly low. Up next, are the Denver Broncos regretting trading for Russell Wilson? It's difficult to see the Russell Wilson deal as anything other than a huge triumph for the Seattle Seahawks at this point. Although Wilson hasn't been up to par for the Denver Broncos, the team has made its bed with him. The Broncos not only acquired Wilson for 2 arms and 2 legs, but they also forfeited $161 million in guaranteed cash to re-sign him before he had played a single snap for the team. The Broncos front office believed that Wilson would be the missing component from a club that has been referred to as a quarterback away for the better part of the last 3 years, just like pretty much everyone else did at the time. Sadly, nothing in Denver has gone as expected thus far in the season. Not only has Wilson performed poorly, he hasn't been good enough, but the Broncos have also been plagued by injuries. The coaching has been woefully inept, and they rank at the bottom of the league in terms of offensive penalties and dropped passes. All of this is not a formula for achievement. It would appear that the Broncos were more than a quarterback away, certainly not in 2022. But the real question is whether the Denver Broncos should regret trading for Russell Wilson. That is a categorical no, is the response. The Broncos had the potential to sign a quarterback who is destined for the Hall of Fame and has a history of only succeeding and performing at a high caliber, if not outstanding level. In his first 10 seasons as a quarterback, Russell Wilson set a record for the most wins in the NFL. Wilson's first 10 NFL seasons saw one of the highest QB ratings ever for a player. When the Broncos acquired him back in March, there was no reason to believe that he or the offense could be this poor because of how outstanding he has been and how consistently competitive the Seahawks have been win in the playoffs. Most general managers would 10 times out of 10 make such a trade. Wilson receiving a contract ahead of the season may have been questionable, but at the time it made sense given the league-wide increase in quarterback salaries. Given that the Broncos have been close in two of the last three seasons and have won 7 games despite some of the worst quarterback play in the league, I believe most people expected Wilson could go out there and throw at least 25 touchdown passes and help the team glide to a winning record. The trade from GM George Patton went fairly smoothly. In retrospect, the preseason contract may have been problematic, but as a general manager, one wouldn't look back and regret the deal that was made. Can the Denver Broncos offense, led by Russell Wilson, turn things around? Possibly. Even taking into account the fact that he had to recover from a severe finger injury, it's difficult to imagine he could be this poor because he played at a much higher level just last season. Russ hasn't cooked much for fans in Denver yet. Everyone anticipated a Wilson-led attack to deliver more than just glimmers of proficiency. Wilson has no choice but to deliver since Denver is under pressure. Will the Denver Broncos' last 7 weeks bring about more of the same? Will Russell Wilson's play begin to elevate the players around him? Let us know what you think in the comment section. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Bye.